Thank you, and good morning again. Madam Shobana Narasimhan, please be ready to come on stage. We are giving you a little resting while over there. They have got to get a chair for you as well. So I'm sorry that you were not here. Can you please arrange a chair for? Okay. After that extremely inspiring speech by Subrat Bagchi, I'm too stunned for words to say anything. I think I'm grateful to him and to Dr. Santrup Mishra for having set the tone for this day today. It's truly, truly mesmerizing what is happening. Helen Keller once said that what is worse than being blind is to have sight but no vision. Somebody also said, if you don't know where you are going, you will end up somewhere else. On the 25th of May, 1961, in a very famous address, John F. Kennedy said, I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving this goal before the decade is out of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely back to Earth. On the 12th of September, 1962, he said, we choose to go to the moon in this decade and do other things not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because the goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills, because that challenge is the one that we are willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one that we intend to win. A very determined bunch of nitrans chanced upon a NITR roadmap working across continents and oceans, and they repurposed it and created a seminal and masterful piece of work that we call the Vision 2025. Jack Welch once said, and this is again has some reference to what the keynote speaker was saying today, that visions are like throwing wet mud packs against a wall. After a while, what sticks, it works, and what doesn't falls away like dried mud. Our vision document is by no means perfect. It is live and will also travel down this path. The good part is that never before in the history has the gap between what can be imagined and what can be accomplished been so small. Sadly, institutions like corporations, when they become old and large, lose an important quality called common sense. We get dangerously caught up in a world of sameness and, as Subrat Bagchi said, incrementalism. We can even forget the very purpose of our existence. We don't ever challenge the idea of an institution. At NIT Rourkela, I wonder if we have become a sausage factory producing clone after clone of engineers with qualifications that we are only oven baking every year for jobs. Or are we breeding a ground of inventors, or a nursery of technology mavericks, or a haven for intellectually restless kids who are irreverently challenging the status quo? Is curiosity an airborne disease on our campus? Why are we so happy about being 12th or 14th on some ranking list? Have century-old universities like Cambridge, Oxford ever lost sleep over rankings? Does an MIT, Stanford, or a Carnegie Mellon care about not being called an Ivy League? MIT's motto is mind and hands. Stanford is nicknamed the factory of billionaires. If you were to chuck a stone in the University of Chicago, chances are that you'll hit a Nobel laureate. At Harvard, if you do not produce a couple of seminal research papers every year, you could forfeit your job as a professor. These iconic institutions have chased their own shadows of excellence and stuck to it day in and day out for years. Our vision document inspires us to be like them. It also says there is no time now left for fine-tuning. We need a chisel and we need a hammer. It is a guts and glory white paper urging us all to relentlessly pursue a path of excellence and to keep our date with our destiny. If you look at NIT Rourkela's mission, it says, advance and spread knowledge in the area of science and technology, leading to the creation of wealth and welfare of humanity. NIT Rourkela's vision is to become an internationally acclaimed institution of higher learning, serve as a source of knowledge and expertise for the society, be a preferred destination for graduate and undergraduate studies. The question I have is, how is it different from any other institution? What is the stake in the ground for us? I remember during my CEO days, I used to tell my people that the difference between a good company and a great company was whether the vision statement in a gilded frame hangs in the boardroom or is it written across the hearts of the people. Vision 2025's overarching intent is to make us spoken of as the top 10 technology institutions in India and among the top 200 to 300 institutions globally by 2025. That's our vision. The vision is built around 7 pillars. The first, cutting-edge research output. At our heart, we must remember that we are a technology institute. Let's never forget that. We know that the world advances on the dogged determination of academic researchers who want to break through all barriers and ceilings and push the frontiers of knowledge. We want to establish 5 multidisciplinary centers of research excellence, called CORE. Shri Lakshman Rao Center of Excellence for Analytics and Decision Sciences has already been established with a financial head start from Venkat Perin himself. In fact, it's named after his father. We also want to wish to target 50 patents a year. We are currently 3 patents compared to 400 each by IIT Chennai and IIT Powai. It is also imperative that we scale sponsored research. But you know, it is a chicken and egg story. If you do good research, the funds will flow. So that's key. The second pillar is to create a world-class faculty pool. Universities in the United States have almost perfected their endowment chair models and attract top faculty talent. We aim to set up 10 chairs for professorships in Rourkela. With generous contributions from the alumni from all over the world, particularly from the US, we have established the Professor Ajay Mahanti, Chair for Electrical Engineering, and we have another chair, which is that of Professor S.S. Pani, which is going to be the Chair for Metallurgy, which is now in the works. This second pillar is also committed to the overall mentorship and the training of faculty to contemporize them with the rest of the world. Professor Prashant Mahapatra, who is here with us today, and one of the shining stars of the institution. For those of you who don't know, he's Vice Chancellor and Dean Research of the University of California, Davis. He himself handles a research fund of $1 billion. So Prasanto has been instrumental in setting up a historic collaboration for us, which was signed off at San Francisco this September. And Professor Bishwas and Professor Damodar Acharya both were there for the signing ceremony with Shantanu. NIT Rourkela has to now live up to this relationship with UC Davis, as it will open the doors and our minds to the workings of a world-class institution. Pillar number 3 is what we call world-class pedagogy and curriculum for the 21st century skills. Technology has grown astronomically, and it has hastened innovation, and it has hastened invention. We cannot be left behind. and must contemporize our education and curriculum in college. We can't still read Theraja after all these years. But then you read the Bible, even it was written so many years ago. God bless Professor Theraja. In the future, there will be only two kinds of technology institutes, ladies and gentlemen. One that will innovate, and the other one which will be dead. The fourth pillar is industry engagement and entrepreneurship ecosystem. We will all die a slow death if we are not relevant. Our theories and research must guard against obsolescence, and we have to constantly stay close to society and industry. Living ordinary lives in India is still very, very hard. But adversity brings with it enormous amount of technology opportunities and hope. There is a national will, which is politically agnostic, to embrace change. We are, as a nation, becoming inclusive, as you saw the kind of work that was done by Subrat Bakshi. And we are in a hurry to digitize. Britain was once called a nation of shopkeepers. We should be called one of startups. Our ETBI, which is Emerging Technologies Business Incubator, could not have come at a better time. It's an initiative that Maheshwar Bhai and Jadumani Jena will soon talk about, the monumental work they have done in the area to boost the NIT startup ecosystem. Later in the day, we'll actually have, the way we are running out of time, I don't know, later in the day, it could be night. we will actually witness live at Investomania our own version of the Shark Tank and watch budding entrepreneurs pitch their ideas to seasoned investors and industry veterans. Pillar number five is scale alumni relations and resource generation. Since morning you've heard this number, we are over 22,000 alumni across the globe. Our might must be felt, our din must be heard. We have to unleash our experience, our intellect, our financial strength and networks to ferry our alma mater, the institution, across to its destination. History will not forgive us if we let this moment go or this momentum go. Nitra Dan is a supreme example of how alumni has come together, and through crowdsourcing of funding, we have raised a perpetual corpus of 2 crores every year for student scholarships. 40 students are supported every year. And another 1.5 crores for student travel research travel. Five, and this was spoken about at some length at the keynote speaker, brand and image revitalization. While we rebuild ourselves in substance and in stature, we cannot ignore the power of perception. We have to emerge from our lengthy shadows and dexterously harness social media and other means which are collapsing geographies. Today is a wonderful day because we are collapsing histories, all of us. But social media is doing geographies. At this event, we have instilled self-belief and made an attempt to project a modern and a confident NIT as a top-notch institution. Every Nitran, again, has the responsibility to embody the brand NIT in terms of being top-notch achievers in your own fields of excellence, high-quality turnout, and in conducting ourselves with a behavior that is befitting of our NIT brand image. We are all brand ambassadors, remember that. Number seven is perhaps the most important pillar, development office and execution. Thomas Edison once famously said, any vision without execution is just a delusion. This seventh pillar holds the key to our entire success. We need sharp focus, we need an organization, we need competent people, we need structures, we need periodic progress reviews, and we need to flag off milestones. This all has to be generously sprinkled with meteoric leadership at the institutional level. Leadership is very key. Teamwork, diligence, grit, and a lot of determination. It's a very hard journey. I believe NITRA must become the refuge of technology revolutionaries. That's the phrase that they use for the Silicon Valley. It's a refuge for technology revolutionaries. Jadu Jena was talking to me once during the early days of ETBI, and he said that he was very despairingly, he said that the ideas were coming in, but in very, very painful trickles. We can always say, my God, the students don't have ideas. I think the fault lies in our DNA. We must examine how do we actually reward and recognize innovation in Rourkela. Would you reward a guy for getting a high-class CGPA, or do you reward a guy who produces drones? We have to check that out. We must, like in investor terms, it is said, we must not stop investing when money runs out. We must only stop investing when we run out of belief. Professor Sugata Mitra, in his famous TED Talks, once said, the job of a teacher is not to teach, but to ask the right questions. It is, however, not a time for all of us to be despondent. We have a long task, but we must raise our eyes to the sunlight, I believe. The faculty, the board, the alumni, and the students are four legs of a formidable table. Our interdependency will be very, very critical. Like other institutions, we are all pilgrims undertaking the same journey. But some pilgrims have better roadmaps. There is an old Chinese saying, the emperor is far away and there are hills in between. This will be a very hard journey. But hard journeys have to be made to scale peaks. I don't think today is just an event. It is another milestone in our hard journey. At the end of today, it is not important about what is said or what is heard, but it is important about how all of us feel. We are all truly excited as we dream together, and I'm going to sign off with an inspiring quote that always takes me across from Sir Siv Sagar Ram Gulam, the late president of Mauritius, and this applies to us. It says, think not of the heights that we have reached, but consider the depths from which we have risen. The impossible we will do right away. It's only the miracles that will take a little longer. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.